Tomorrow, Kenya will hold its general elections to elect the fifth president since independence. The highly competitive race is between the current deputy president, William Ruto, who is running for the United Democratic Alliance, UDA, and former prime minister, Raila Odinga, who is running under the Azimio La Umoja, One Kenya coalition. Just hours to the polls, people fleeing from Kenya to Uganda have increased in the past 3 days. These are mostly Ugandans working and living in Kenya, and some Kenyans too are fleeing.
We are experiencing an increased volume of traffic coming in from Kenya, especially through Busia border and Lwakhakha. We have volumes of traffic has increased threefold. We do not know whether it is because of the elections coming up tomorrow in Kenya or some, but most of these people coming in are Ugandans who are returning home.
Mundeyi further noted that whereas they are not sure of a reason for this, they suspect that many are anticipating violence stemming from tomorrow's election. The numbers are, however, expected to rise by the end of the day.
Whenever there is an election, I think they have some sense of fear, so some of them return home to first watch the situation as it unfolds, then return after the elections. So we have experienced a big number, especially in Busia and Lwakhakha. The other borders like Malava and Swam River are still normal. The numbers are still normal, but we do hope those numbers to increase by close of today.
Still about the Kenyan elections, the Uganda Police Force are on high alert ahead of tomorrow's election. According to police spokesperson Fred Enanga, should there be any form of post-election violence in neighboring Kenya, the Uganda Police Force are to ensure that this does not spill over to the Ugandan
state. We do not anticipate any possibilities of civil unrest. As the joint security agencies, we continue to pay close attention to the electoral climate in Kenya. As always, we have contingency plans in case of any potential scenarios impacting our citizens along the borderlines of Uganda with Kenya. We are also happy to inform the country that government has mitigated plans against any disruption of goods and cargo through Kenya, through the alternative route of Tanzania.
Meanwhile, the Ministry of Internal Affairs has revoked the mandatory medical examination for flying abroad for. This had been introduced as part of the efforts to counter claims of illegal organ harvest. However, in the latest development, it has been suspended after numerous complaints.
Has revoked that requirement after realizing that, first of all, it costs some bit of money, and then on an understanding that these girls already have some medical examination done by their companies, and I think Minister of Gender. So the minister revoked after listening to several groups and consulting several groups of people.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, a total of 60 people died in road crashes in the past 1 week. The majority of these road crashes have been attributed to reckless driving. Meanwhile, the traffic police has resorted to a name and shame campaign to bring sanity among motorists. A list of over 100 reckless drivers has been read out and will be published in the newspapers.
As 145 vehicles arrested last week by cameras misbehaving on the road. So the list has the number plate of the car, the date when you committed the offense, the time, on which road, we have which camera captured you, the offense you committed, the make of your car and the color.
From the National Task Force Against Human Trafficking, Samuel Musasizi, a medical doctor, is being accused of attempting to traffic over 37 people from whom he extorted money, promising them to secure jobs in Dubai.
Musasizi Samuel has a clinic called Royal Health Medical Center in Biogerere, Kirinya. So what he did, he claimed that he's going to take people abroad, you know, to work. And so he recruited 37 who gave him money from a tune. Some gave 10 million, 10 million, 5 million. The list gave 1 million. So he said, so the jobs promised were included receptionist, secretary, security guards. So those are both male and women, cashiers. And then only to realize that he's an agent. He was working as an agent. He claims to take people under T27 in Dubai.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.